Hey guys, welcome to my channel. My name is Brittany Timberlake. If you haven't yet subscribed, please do and hit the bell icon so you don't miss any future practices. I'm calling this practice a yin and meditation class. A yin class in of itself is very meditative in nature, but for this particular practice, I'd like to hold some extra time at the end for a seated meditation. And if you're not comfortable sitting for 15 to 20 minutes, that's perfectly fine. You're welcome to lay down or even sit on a chair. So we'll leave that extra time at the end. For this practice, you're going to need two blocks. You're going to need a bolster and a blanket. Let's get started in supported fish. We'll take our bolster to the back of the mat. You could have your bolster laying down right on the floor, or if you'd like a little elevation today, you could place one of the blocks underneath. And we'll bring the very base of the spine here, the bum, right to the base of the bolster, and then we'll start to lay back. We'll just let our legs splay out. We'll take our arms by our sides. Just taking a few moments to get comfortable on your bolster. You might like to close your eyes. Allowing the weight of the legs to feel heavy on the floor. Allowing the spine to feel supported by the bolster. Right away, we're moving into a back bend. We're compressing the lower spine. We're opening through the chest and the shoulders. Letting the belly feel really soft. Feeling the torso expand on the breaths in. Gently collapse on the breaths out. Eventually finding a breath that feels steady and rhythmic for you. Taking notice of what the mind is doing. You can imagine that the thoughts are like clouds in the sky. And we notice the clouds in the sky, and then we just let them float on by, knowing that eventually another cloud or another thought's going to make their way into our view. And that we just notice, and then let them move on by. On our next breath in, we'll reach the arms up overhead, reaching through the fingertips, all the way down through the toes, roll up the ankles and the wrists a couple times. And then we'll take our elbows just by our sides and slowly press our way up off the bolster. We're going to come into a wide-legged fold or dragonfly. So you could, right from here, take the legs out into a wide V. Or you could have sensitive heels, so you could come to face the long edge of your mat, just moving your bolster off to the side. So as we come to face the long edge of our mat, you can place the heels on the mat. The hips could be up onto a blanket. And finding a width that's comfortable for you. This doesn't have to be super wide or aggressive. Starting to fold forward. The legs are relaxed. You could have any extra support under the knees. You could always have your blocks underneath your forehead or underneath your elbows. And in Dragonfly, we are targeting the backs of the legs. So you could be feeling quite a bit of sensation through the hamstrings, the calves. Targeting the inner groin. So quite a bit of sensation could be happening through the adductors. So slow, we'll start to come back up. We'll just pause at the top, letting the shoulders come down and away from the ears. And then opening the eyes, you can use your hands to gently bend one knee and then the other. Normal to feel a little bit tender or fragile after that. We'll bring the knees together and then just let the knees rock side to side. So I would like to give you an option for the next shape. So we're looking to target the inner groin, but we're going to get the hamstrings out of the way this time. So A, if you have really sensitive knees today, you could just bring the soles of the feet together, knees fall out, coming into a seated butterfly, and then rounding forward. Or you could come into frog. So facing the long edge of our mat, we'll take our blanket so we have some extra padding for the knees. We'll just lay that out. And you could have your bolster just close by in case you want to use that. So coming with the knees wide on the mat, you could have your toes pointing out, your toes pointing in. You can try both on, and you can stay up on your hands, the hips sinking back slightly. You could come down onto your forearms, or you might even come down onto your bolster. So whether you're in seated butterfly or frog, we'll gently make our way up, moving any props off to the side. If you're in seated butterfly, you might like to just let the knees fall side to side. If you're in frog, you could come all the way forward onto the floor. You might like to inch one knee in and then the other. Just coming to sit on your shins. And then we'll come down to lay on our bellies. I'm just letting the forehead rest on stacked palms, or you could have your arms behind you resting on a cheek. Becoming aware of the sensations in the lower body. Reconnecting to the breath if we've lost the connection to the here and the now. We're going to make our way into Sphinx. A couple of options. You could come up onto the elbows so they're right underneath our shoulders. You could have your legs close together or wide apart. If you would like to come up a little higher, you could reach for your bolster and bring the elbows onto the bolster, maybe even resting part of your upper torso or chest on the bolster. So if you're coming up a little higher on the bolster, we're bringing the compression a little further up into the spine, moving the compression a little up above the lumbar vertebrae into the thoracic vertebrae. And you could let your head hang back or hang forward. You could let the shoulders come up by the ears. Not worrying about how you look. It's all about how you feel. very slowly and mindfully we'll release from Sphinx. Just allowing yourself to come down onto the belly. Imagining that you could send your breath all the way down to the lower back. The inhales creating space. And the exhales releasing stress and tension. We'll bring our hands to the outsides of our ribs so we can lift up and back into a child's pose. You could take this with the knees close together or wide apart. And I'd like to give you an option to not only get this opening in the hips and a decompression in the lower back, but if you want to have a bit of an opening through the shoulders, you could take that right arm and just slide it underneath the left and come to rest on the right shoulder and the right side of the head. If you have that right arm slid underneath the left, we'll release reaching that right arm forward, switching sides, the left arm reaches underneath the right, coming to lay onto the left shoulder and left side of the head. Take our time to release from that side and then lifting all the way up onto our shins. And we'll take our blanket and fold it up just a little bit so we've got that little bit of elevation for the hips as we move into another forward fold. We're going to come into shoelace and we'll move through half shoelace to start. So extending the left leg out in front, bending the right knee, crossing the right leg over the left. Now you might stay right here. This could be more than enough sensation through the outer right T-band and hip. Or you could start to fold forward. You could also take full shoelace where you bend the bottom knee and stack the knees or have the knees somewhere in that direction. And as you come forward, if you have a lot of range, you might come all the way down. Your forehead could be resting on blocks. Sometimes I will put my bolster at a bit of an angle and rest my forehead on that. Finding your edge and then maybe backing off a little bit. Finding a little bit of stillness. And And we'll hang out here for a little bit of time. So that as the muscles relax, the targeted areas become a little bit more supple, more flexible. And if you're folded forward, we'll just bring some weight into the fingertips as we slowly roll up. Leaning back onto the hands, unravel the legs. You could just extend the legs out in front of you. Or you might like to take the knees from side to side. We'll move into either half or full shoelace on the other side. Extending the right leg out in front, bending the left knee. And that knee comes somewhere over the right leg. Trying this on. And then if feeling okay, folding forward or bending the bottom knee. So don't get too hung up on stacking the knees or looking how I look. Just finding a shape with the lower body so that you can feel some sensation through the outer left hip. So if you feel that, then you're doing it right. Coming forward, taking time to set up any props. And although we resolve to remain still, you might notice that as time goes on and the body softens, the body might tell you that it's okay to go a little bit deeper. So in that moment, if you need to shift or move to change the areas that you're targeting, then that's perfectly fine. Releasing from this side. I'll unravel the legs. And then we'll come to just lay down on our backs. We'll rebound on the back. You might like to take the arms up overhead. Just letting the legs and the arms soften. Letting the body take up space. Bend the knees and draw the knees in towards the chest. You could use your hands to give the legs a little squeeze. And then just taking a couple of lazy twists from side to side, using your core to help the legs fall from left to right. The arms could be out into a T. And as we move into our meditation, you could choose to stay laying down here on your back. You might like to sit in a chair or sit up against a wall. Otherwise, we'll find something comfortable to sit up onto. Rolling out through the shoulders. So we've spent the last little while really priming the body for this. And closing the eyes or just having a soft gaze on the floor. Just letting the hands rest comfortably. If you're sitting, allowing the pelvis to feel rooted as the crown of the head reaches up towards the sky, the shoulders fall comfortably down and away from your ears. And there's nothing fancy or special that you have to do right now. And you might like to focus on the inhales and exhales. There might be a mantra that you like to focus on. Maybe something like on the inhale, you think, I am. And on the exhale, thinking here now. But really, it's all about spending a little bit of quiet time with yourself, just observing your patterns of thought. Observing what's going on in the body, holding it all in a non-judgmental way. I'll bring a little bit of awareness back into the body, just moving your fingers, toes, if you're laying down. Open the eyes if they're closed. I hope that you can bring some of this calm and ease with you into the rest of your day and evening. Bring your hands together at our heart. Namaste.